Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Take Two Radio. This is Pam, your host, and with me is my guest co-host, who I love and adore, Mike Litzkin. Hi,
hey.
Mike. How are you?
Hey, Pam. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. Weather's beautiful. We have a guest today. You're with me. What more can I ask for?
Exactly. You know, that's one change we had since last week. Last week,
right?
I had the beautiful weather, and you had, like, winter, so something changed for Chicago.
Yeah, it finally decided that it was going to bring on the spring. So here
Yay.
We are.
Yay. All righty then.
Well, today we welcome a musician who has been in many well-known bands such as Spirit and Blowin' Smoke and who has recently started a new band called Sky King. So today we welcome bassist, vocalist, and band leader Larry Fuzzy Knight. Welcome, Larry.
How are you guys doing today?
We're doing good, and we're happy to have you.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased to be here.
You're welcome. So how's your weather?
It is unbelievably beautiful. The weather is warm. The skies are blue and cloudy, and it's the reason why I live in Southern California.
Yeah. I can't
sure.
say I blame you there. You and
Remember,
Mike got it made.
I'm from St. Louis, so I you know what the winters are like.
Yes.
And you know what the humidity is like in the summer. And you know what the mosquitoes are like. You know? So, yeah, I fled to California, you know, and I really do. I really am addicted to SoCal weather. It's wonderful.
I remember one time traveling across country, my first real experience with the Midwest, and some friends and myself went to the St. Louis Zoo in July, and I, for some reason, wore blue jeans, and you don't do that. It's 100 degrees and humid. You don't do that in St. Louis.
Right. Yeah, your pants will stick to your body for the next 2 years.
Yes.
Well, you guys were the smart ones running and not looking back, and I
yeah,
hope to
you
someday
you
someday
believe
do
it.
That.
I think they were still getting snow in St. Louis up to a couple weeks ago.
Mm. Oh, yeah. We had flurries last week.
Yeah,
I
exactly.
mean, nothing stuck, but at least, you know, oh, my gosh. I just wanted it over with already.
Yeah, well, I think you're well on your way. You're getting closer, at least, to something that resembles spring.
Right?
Yep.
All right.
If not, I'm coming knocking on one of your guys' doors. That's all.
There you go.
There you go.
Well, Larry, as I said, you've been in, you know, a few bands and very well known. You're very accomplished, and you've done so much in your life musically. Before we get into that, can you tell us about your new venture with Sky King?
Yes. Sky King started about almost 2.5-3 years ago, and it sort of happened by accident because I was rehearsing with a different group in a rehearsal studio, and I met a couple musicians that were in the room next door, and they were at that particular time looking for a bass player, so they approached me and asked me if I would have any interest, and I said, well, I'd like to listen to your material, I'd like to listen to your songs, and at the rehearsal studio, they were playing their music, but it was loud and distorted, and the acoustics weren't very good. And so I asked the lead guitarist, whose name is Walter Morosco, I asked him, why don't you come out to my house and bring your friend Garth Farkas, who these two guys went to grade school together and have been friends together all their lives, and both of them are from Youngstown, Ohio. So they're good Midwestern boys.
Yeah.
And they came out to my place and sat down, and I really had an opportunity to listen to the lyric, understand what all the lyrics were to every song, and the vibe of the song, the melody, and so on and so forth. And I thought, well, you know, you've got something very very, very identifiable with people in your music. And we actually spent the last, from that point on, we spent close to a year and a half rewriting the music to all the songs. There's 13 original tracks. And when we were all done doing that, and I am the producer of the album and the music arranger of the album, we went in the studio. We laid down 13 basic tracks. We had it rehearsed so well that we did all 13 tracks in a day and a half.
Wow.
And that's a lot of recording, you know. But
yeah.
we knew every note backwards and forwards by then, so we were extremely pre-produced, you know, for those sessions. And it went really well. And the songs, the title of the CD is called Morose Tales from the Left Coast. And we came up with that title after listening and understanding the sequence of the songs that we put on the CD. It's a story, basically. It's almost a concept album of the quest to come to the West Coast, or the Left Coast, as we call it.
Yep.
You know, searching for success in music. And the majority of people that come out here, you know, really never make it. And the very small percentage that do, they usually don't wind up staying out here anyway. They move somewhere else. But there's a sort of a fantasy to coming out to the West Coast, you know, Hollywood and all that. And I think people are extremely disillusioned after a few years of struggling out here.
Mm-hmm.
And the stories of that survival and what you go through, a lot of that is in the music of the Sky King Band. And it's the experiences of Walter Marosco basically living in North Hollywood and you know, struggling over the years to become known for his music. And it's not easy when you've got thousands of bands out here willing to play anywhere for free.
Right.
So just getting in and trying to make a living at what you're doing is not easy. That's one illusion, that you're going to come out here and make a great living, you know, playing in nightclubs. You don't make a great living playing in nightclubs in Southern California, and probably anywhere else in the country right now, for that matter. But you know, and then there's just the imagery. What you think Hollywood is, and what you think Los Angeles is all about, and that's what the song is. That's what the CD is all about. It's about the struggle, and it's about winning and losing, and having these very strange experiences out here on the West Coast. So that's Morose Tales from the Left Coast. That's what the album's all about.
Wow. It sounds like it's something that any budding musician or actor or any kind of artist that's thinking that they're going to make it in Hollywood, they ought to just go ahead and give a listen to this first and just kind of be forewarned before they come out.
Well, you never know, you know. Now, there's a song on there called Oxnard Cahuenga, and that happens to be two streets that intersect with each other in an area called North Hollywood. And that's where the guitarist lives. The song is basically, strangely enough, it's about a real occurrence that used to happen all the time with the gangs, drive-by shootings.
Mm.
And it's about this little girl that was standing in the doorway. This is a true story. And she was hit by a stray bullet, and she was killed.
Oh.
And, you know, when you come out to L.A., from Youngstown, Ohio, when you know, you get out here and you're living in your neighborhood, I think the last thing you're thinking about is somebody driving by and, you know, accidentally killing a little, you know, 2 or 3 year old child. But these are some of the daily experiences that can happen to you living here on the left coast. So you never know. You never know.
Oh, and I know exactly where you're talking about, too. I grew up right next to North Hollywood in Van Nuys, and that was definitely a place that had some tough moments. And it was so interesting growing up there because people say, it's Hollywood, it's glamour. I always thought, no, you should come out and see it. It's not quite what you think it is.
No. You know, I remember, listen, when I drove across country in 1969, and that's when I arrived out here in Los Angeles, and I saw Hollywood Boulevard for the very first time after 10 p.m. at night. It was the scariest place in the world. I mean, there are the crazies, the hookers, the druggies, you know, the you name it, and it's all weird, and it's all down there, you know, after 10 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
I got, well, wait a second, where's the stars? Where's all the glitter? Where's all the beauty, you know? And you know, it's just the way it is, you know? It's smoke and mirrors a lot of times.
That was, of course, the illusion was more back in the 1930s and 40s, the glamour era, that's for sure. From what I understand, though, they're making strides at making Hollywood and North Hollywood a little bit better. I think North Hollywood
they're
is a bit more artsy.
They're working their tails up, yes. NoHo, as it's called now, North Hollywood, is becoming a more of a club area and restaurant area. Yeah, they are. They're working very, very hard to clean up these places and turn them into, you know, more of a place for entertainment and more of a place for people to go out and even tourists to go and, you know, check things out and in a nicer environment, so to speak.
Wow. Well, that's good. So that way when the newbies walk in there, they're not going to be frightened right off the bat. So
hopefully not. You know, hopefully not. You know, that's the deal. But
yeah.
But it's a great, you know, my reason was not just to come out for the entertainment and for the record industry and all that, but, you know, I really did want to get away from the harsh winters and the humid summers. And, you know, I came to Southern California because I really do appreciate this weather out here. It's like you have no idea during the winter when you're sitting here watching the weather reports around the country, and you keep saying to yourself every day, gosh, how lucky we are to live here in Southern California.
Yes, and you know, especially New Year's Day when they show the Tournament of Roses parade and the Rose Bowl game, and everybody across the country is seeing blue skies and a sunny day. Now, it may pour rain on January 2nd, but it's always perfect on New Year's Day.
Yes, T-shirts and shorts.
Mm-hmm.
Down there in Pasadena, you know, it's just a great, it's really great. That's one of my waving the flags for SoCal is the weather. That's it. That's number one on my list. It might be the only number on my list, by the way.
That's right.
You know,
well, Larry, if you wouldn't mind, I'd love to play one of the songs by Sky King now and
no,
then we
I
can
mind.
Chat about it.
I don't
it.
Want you to do that. We want you to do that. No.
I think our listeners
Prince,
would
yeah,
be.
But no, let's go for it.
Okay, I'm going to play Late Night Phone Call by Sky King.
Oh, cool. Oh, great. There's some great musicianship on there. After you're done with it, I'd like to talk about some of the players.
Oh, definitely.
Are on the recording, by the way.
Okay, sounds great. Let's go ahead and play it now.
You got it.